Ladies and gentlemen, in this video we are going to talk about how political leaders manipulate mass population to get their own way straight. Let's get started. People are vulnerable when they are in depression, they are going through learned helplessness, and also they are out of the basic survival instinct or going through some transition. Some may have lost their job, or for example, students who are living far away from the home, or they lost loved one, or feeling lonely or lost. In this case, imagine someone who come there to talk to them, invite them in their meeting. It might be gathering of some religious activity, political activity, agenda, whether you call it self-help, seminar, or whatever the case. It might be something like practicing yoga, meditation, or something like that. In this case, we simply say different people have different reason to lure people in. When they go to that seminar, they feel love is bombing. They talk about positivity and they compliment people, and leader speak their language and what they have in their mind. It will create a strong connection and bond, and they will take great extent to protect that group. They simply appeal to emotional brain, and each of these political leaders use easy to catch word or verbal. Sometimes they will talk against another leader, how bad he is, and all they want to feel their audience to against them. Goal here is he has to build up the masses, which represent the irrational sentiment of the people and group. In this case, I would like you to remember Hitler, how Hitler was born, because when there was World War II, Germany economy was weak, they did not forget humiliation from the recent World War. Also, that point of time, people were under depression, they had gone through great transition, and also they were hoping for the better future. And this moment, Hitler came to capitalize this moment to sense of hope. A different politician will use different technique to manipulate people. Another is scapegoat technique. If person is suffering and why he is there and how other people make him this way and misery behind this suffering, and same time another political leader come up with some kind of gratitude to the person and told him he is used and he has better future waiting for him. So imagine how much this person will follow this political leader. Another very well-known theory is divide and rule. When people divide, they have great sense of purpose to protect our group, our heart. They will have motivation to defend our group, and they will go great length to adopt their own culture and rituals and their belief. That's why you can see in Nepal context, there are so many leaders, they want to divide different kind of caste and religion, and they want to play the future of the people. Ladies and gentlemen, there is different way to control the mind, and another is mystical manipulation. What do I mean by that? Mystical manipulation means some people, they claim themselves guru, or they are the meditation guru or spiritual guru or something like that, and let other people listen, watch them, and they will get huge return on their favor. Now imagine if same political leader who reach into the government and become president or prime minister, he is not only party president or prime minister, he is the prime minister for all the people in nation, and running nation is very enormous job. So when bad thing happen, he is not prepared, he cannot handle things. That's how he will not survive for their own terms. In this case, when he failed to finish his terms, again he will start to manipulate people with another propaganda. That's why this all the political leaders, they come up with different method. They don't have idea, they only create controversy. They will not encourage people for cooperation, but they will always bring division among the society. Also, they never inspire hope, they always inspire fear, and they just want to simply tap the people emotion and cast fake promises. You can see how Puspa Kamal Dahal will talk against KP Oli, how KP Oli will talk against Puspa Kamal Dahal, and how Baburam Bhattarai every single minute tweets on the internet. Imagine if same people reach in the government, do you think they will develop nation? They will build up your future? Obviously not, because they are not prepared, they are not ready, they are busy with belittling one another, they are so much concerned with spreading fake propaganda. So question remain, if you want to let them be credible and responsible leader, stop supporting their fake promises and stop clapping their manipulative approach. It simply means you are digging graveyard for yourself. At the end of the day, it's not the leader who changed the nation, it's you. What kind of leader?